this lecture we are going to discuss the Wilson theorem. So what the Wilson theorem is, if p is an odd prime number and p minus 1 factorial when divided by p gives the remainder minus 1, means p minus 1 factorial congruence minus 1 mod p. So I'll take a one simple example so that you understand it a better way. Let's say p I take is 11. So p minus 1 factorial is 10 factorial, and this 10 factorial can be written as 1 into 2 into 3 into 4 into 5 into 6 into 7 into 8 into 9 into 10. Now I'll rearrange this product and I can write in a different manner, that is 1 into 10. We can write 2 into 6 and 3 into 4. 5 into 9 and 7 into 8. And this can be written as a 10. Here you get 12. Here I'll get 12. Here I'll get 45. And here I'll get 56. Now when this 12 is divided by 11, I'll get the remainder 1. This 12 is divided by 11, I'll get the remainder 1. This 45 divided by 11 will give the remainder 1. 56 divided by 11 will give the remainder 1. But when this 10 is divided by 11, I will get the remainder 10 or minus 1. So the negative remainder I have already explained in my earlier lectures. And we also know that if A congruence B modulo n, A dash congruence B dash modulo n, A double dash congruence B double dash modulo n. So, we already know that this can be written as A into A dash, A double dash, congruence B into B dash into B double dash modulo n. So, we can write this way. So, when I'm dividing now, this product when I divide by 11, so here I'll get the congruence 1, here I'll get the congruence 1 modulo 11, here I'll get 1. Remainder, and here I'll get remainder 1, and this side I'll get minus 1. So we can write that when 10 factorial is divided by 11, I'll get the remainder minus 1. So we can write 10 factorial congruence minus 1 modulo 11. Now I'll try to develop the generalized form of this Wilson theorem. Means we'll prove this Wilson theorem. It's very easy to understand. Actually, we need to prove a little bit of linear congruence equation, which you already know that we know from the linear congruences that AX congruent 1 mod P, then there exists one unique value of X from the set 1, 2, 3, dot 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 p minus 1 if GCD, that is the greatest common divisor of A and P, is 1. So this is what we already know. Now what we need to prove, that two important things we need to prove, that both A and X, first of all, belong to the set 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, up to dot 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 p minus 1. So the value of X will obviously lie in this set only, anywhere. This is already proved, and I have given this thing in the linear congruences, which you can revise from my earlier lecture. I will give the link of that in the description box. So if it is written that AX congruence 0 mod P, incongruent 0 mod P, that means both A and X are not divisible by P. So basically we have to prove that there exists a sum X there for which AX congruence 1 mod P, and A is also been taken from these sets only. So this is what we are going to prove. So First of all, that ax incongruent 0 mod p, that means neither a nor x are divisible by p. So the second thing we will write, that we get a unique value over there. So let's say I take x and y are two distinct numbers from set A, and we assume that x is greater than y, that ax incongruent ay mod p. So that can be written as a into x minus y incongruent mod p. So obviously, if I have taken x is greater than y, so the value of x minus y will obviously lie in this set only. So that means a and x minus y both are not divisible by p. So that means we can write that ax is incongruent ay mod p. So that means for some x, I'll get one value, some different y, I'll get a different value. So there has to be one value x over there. For that, I'll get one there. So I think now it's clear to you. The application of this Wilson theorem in basically the in regional maths Olympiad and Indian National Maths Olympiad are far reaching. So I'll taking few of the examples so that you understand it in a better way. You are asked find the remainder when 97 factorial is divided by 101. So this 101 is an odd prime number. So we know when 100 factorial divided by 101 will leave the remainder minus 1. So but here we are given the 97 factorial. So what I'll do, I'll write 100 into 99 into 98 into 97 factorial congruence minus 1 modulo 101. So now what I'll do here, obviously when 100 is divided by 101, the remainder I'll get 100 or minus 1. So we get remainder minus 1. When 99 is divided by 101, the remainder I'll get minus 2. When 98 is divided by, we'll get the remainder minus 3. Into 97 factorial congruence minus 1 mod 101. So this we can write, that is 6 into 97 factorial, the other side the minus 1 I will also utilize, this is 1 modulo 101. Now from the set of the numbers from 1, 2, 3 up to 100, I have to pick a number which when multiplied with 6 leave the remainder 1, so that I can multiply that number both the side, and I will be using that the linear congruences equation which I have just explained you. So you know that the 17 into 6, that I'll get 102, and this 102 when divided by 101 will leave the remainder 1. So both the sides I'll multiply by 17. 17 into 6 into 97 factorial congruence 17 modulo 101. Now I hope it is clear to you. So this is 102, and 102 when divided by 101 leave the remainder 1. So 1 into 97 factorial. So that is 97 factorial. So we can write this 97 factorial will get the remainder 17 modulo 101. So when this 97 factorial is divided by 101, you will get the remainder 17. So I hope it is clear to you. So one more problem I'll explain to you, and this problem The next problem standard is, it's a National Maths Olympiad problem standard is. Problem says, if P is a prime such that P congruence 1 modulo 4, then show that P minus 1 divided by 2 factorial whole square congruence minus 1 mod P. Means P is a prime number, when it is divided by 4 leaves the remainder 1. Then you have to prove that the P minus 1 upon 2 factorial whole square when divided by P leaves the remainder minus 1. So I can write this P as a sum number in the form of 4k plus 1. So now see, this P is a 4k plus 1. So our P minus 1 factorial will be 4k factorial. So this 4k factorial can be written as a 2k factorial and then 2k plus 1, 2k plus 2, and finally 2k plus 2k. We can write like this. As I have written P is equals to 4k plus 1, so I can write P is equals to 2k plus 2k plus 1, and then we can write 2k is equals to P minus 2k plus 1. So we can write like this. 2k plus 1 can be written as a P is equals to P minus 2k can be written as 2k plus 1. So that value 2k plus 1 we will substitute here. It is a 2k factorial. The next value will become p minus 2k factorial. Sorry, pk not factorial. That's and then p minus 2k. The next will become p minus 2k minus 1. And finally, this 2k plus 2k, which is 4k, can be written as p minus 1. So now, if I get the modulo of this one, you see, when this is divided, let's say I go with the p minus 2k congruence minus 2k modulo p. So when I divide this, I'll definitely get the minus 2k as a remainder. So if I divide this one, this is a 2k factorial. Here I'll get the remainder is minus 2k when divided by p. Here I'll get the remainder is minus of 2k minus 1. And finally, here I'll get minus 1. Modulo p. So this can be written as a 2k factorial, and rest of this minus 2k minus 2k minus 1 up to minus 1, we have total 2k number of minus signs are there. So we can write this as a 2k, then we can write 2k minus 1 up to dot 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 3 2 1 into minus 1 raised to the power 2k mod p. And you see, this minus 1 raised to the power 2k will become plus 1. So this is a 2k factorial. And starting from 2k up to 1, we can write this is again 2k factorial modulo p. So this is a 2k factorial. Now if I get the 2k's value, you can see there, we can find the 2k's value. So 4k is basically p minus 1. You can see from here, 4k is p minus 1. So 2k can be written as a p minus 1 divided by 2. So this I can write p minus 1 divided by 2 factorial whole square. And you see, the modulo this, I'll get this is an modulo P. So this, as you are getting this 4k factorial, when you divide by this 4k factorial is basically p minus 1 factorial. So from the Wilson theorem we know that we will get the minus 1. So here I'll get this is equal. So as I have written 4k factorial in this form, so when I 4k factorial congruence minus 1, which is p minus 1, leave the remainder minus 1. So this will also leave the remainder minus 1. So we can write p minus 2 factorial whole square congruence minus 1 mod p. I think it's clear to you. In the coming lectures, we'll take the few IMO problems so that you understand and you can apply in the problems. Thank you.